This is an x-ray tube, complete with the housing. That's bought from eBay. Unfortunately, it's broken. The tube itself was oil cooled. There's two pipes for the oil. High voltage connection goes in here. And in the front, this is the window where x-rays are emitted. It came complete with filters that presumably go there, but the thread's not quite right. The actual x-ray tube can be seen in here. These two wires are the heater wires. This front cover off, this is the beryllium window that the x-rays are emitted from. And this connection is part of the heater, which is onto this part of the tube. Unscrew the housing. See the other heater connection there. And this should release the tube assembly. I've removed the oil from the inside, and that does the anode connection on the spring, which connects to the connector in the housing. This is the little x-ray tube itself. And if we look closely, there's a couple of small getters here, and they are actually white, which suggests that there's probably air in the vacuum. Well, air has got in. So there's no point trying to run up the heaters because it would just smoke and burn out. But we could try and confirm it by putting the HT on it. Right, I've connected the anode and one side of the heater up to the high voltage supply, and if I turn the voltage up, I should hear breakdown if there's air in it. That's just over 2 kV. Ah. At 10 kV you can hear the clicking noise of the arc inside the tube. So we've confirmed we've lost the vacuum and we've got a paperweight rather than an x-ray. No signs of where it's actually let in air, other than there's a very, very small dent in the beryllium window. Just here. It doesn't look bad, but it may be just enough to have let air in. There's certainly no cracks on the glass. This may be worth looking inside it, because being this the window where the x-rays come out and the anode's here, I'm not sure how the construction would be. Normally in an x-ray tube like this one, we have the heaters here and the anode here, and the anode's angled so that the beam strikes the anode and the x-rays are emitted through here. Tried that hot wire technique, but didn't work particularly well, but it did manage to break the glass eventually. It's not very clean break though. This is rather interesting. This looks like the actual anode target here. This is possibly copper on the anode. The heater is still inside here. I can actually buzz it out. So we've got one connection there to the other. So somewhere in here is still a heater. There is a little bit of strange marking on the beryllium window, just on the inside from this dent here. So possibly that's where the vacuum failed. I can't quite see the heater, but I'm guessing it's in there. I need to break this open to see. Confirmed it's the window that failed. If I put a very, very bright light on the back of the window, maybe just make out that a speck of light gets through. So that's where we lost our vacuum, or where we're air getting. Connected up the heaters here rather than actually take it any further apart. You can just see the glow from the heater. Oh, and that's the end of the heater.